All right. So what we're going to do now, we just did this example, the first example for dictation. The huge dog ate 3 out of 4 of my candies. And Grace told us the fraction was 3/4. So now you have your red, green, and blue crayons. Let's look here. So what is this word?
Noun.
Noun. And we have a circle around it. What's this word?
Verb.
Verb. And you can see it's underlined, and I put a V under it. And it's red. And this green word is what?
Adjective.
Adjective. So I put a little box around it, and I put an A under it. Who can tell me from yesterday, who remembers what is a noun? Can you give me an example?
Person, place, thing.
Or an idea, that's right. Who can give me an example?
Make a sentence?
No, just an example of a noun.
School.
School.
Chair.
Chair. Rhea? Pencil. Pencil, right? Those are all things, okay? Is this a noun? United States.
Yeah.
Yes, it's a place, right? All right, so that one's pretty easy, right? Now, in this sentence, we have 2 nouns. 2 nouns. Can you take it? Remember, a noun is a person, place, thing, or idea, right? So here, there are 2 things. Can anybody tell me what the first noun is?
Candies.
Well, that's one of them, yes. So let's, with your blue crayon, circle candies. And let's put an N underneath for a noun. All right, so Nathan found the first noun. What is the other noun? Does anybody see? Kevin?
Dog.
Dog, yes. So circle dog and put an N. All right, so we identified our 2 nouns. Now let's go on to the verb. All right, some sentences have more than one verb, but they always have one main verb. So this sentence has one main verb, the most important verb. So remember, verbs, in this case, we're going to talk about action verbs, you know, like sleep, talk, run, jump.
Huge.
No, not huge. That eight. Describes. What is it?
Eight.
Eight. Yeah. Eight. Now, this is the past tense of what? Eight is the past tense of eat. Past tense means it just happened in the past. So the present tense is eat. But here we have eight. So let's circle 8 with your red crayon and write a V either above it or below it. Make sure you put that V so you see that it's a verb. All right, now the last one is what?
Adjective.
Adjective. We have, okay, we're going to do just one main adjective in this sentence. And remember, an adjective is a word that describes. Yesterday when I said I had a car, right, you don't know what kind of car, but if I said I have a new, expensive, fast, clean car, those were all adjectives, words that will describe something. Okay, so Kevin, what was it?
Huge.
Huge. What does huge mean?
It's big dog.
Yeah, really big dog, right? So let's put a box around huge, and either above it or below it.
Oh, you did something wrong. An 8, underline.
What's that? Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay, so it's okay for the first one. This is just an example. Kevin told us that we circled the verb instead of underlining. So that's good. If you want, you don't have to worry about it because you wrote it in crayon. I can fix it on the board. All right, so thank you for that. I'm going to just underline it. So now for the next one, for number one, make sure you remind me to, let's underline the verb, okay? All right, so Grace, what we did here is we circled the nouns. And in this sentence, we have two nouns. Nouns are the names of people, places, things. And they found dog. So take your blue crayon. Okay, circle dog and candies. Put an N there so we know that it's a noun. Then we underline 8. That's our verb. And we wrote a V either above it or below it.
Yeah, so,
huh? It's okay. So if you made a mistake, we made a mistake too. We circled it instead of underlining and then we changed it. So, all right, just scribble it out or whatever. But just make sure you have a V beside the, this is the verb. And this one was what?
Adjective.
Words that describe, right? So huge, what kind of dog? A huge dog. So draw a box around it and put an A. All right, so now we're going to do number one. Count, how many words do we have for number one? Count them up. That was for the example.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Is it 8?
9, 10.
No.
11.
Is it? 1. Oh, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, the last word. Can you guess what the last word is going to be? It's a word that is difficult for a lot of people to spell, but you use it at least once a week.
Wednesday.
Yeah, Wednesday.
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 How do you spell it?
Yeah, it's going to be a hard one. Well, I tell you what, you can see how many letters it is, right? Each one of those spaces is a letter. So listen to how I say it. Wednesday. But Wednesday. So because look, that third letter is what? A D. But it's very, most people don't pronounce it. How do you say that word?
Wednesday.
Yeah, most people say it like that. But it's not spelled, it sounds different than what it looks. So what do you think the second letter is?
E.
Yeah. All right, so you could go ahead, write E in that second space. Okay, Wednesday. What do you think that fourth letter is?
N.
N. That's right. So from there, okay, then you can figure out the rest. But for now, I'm going to read sentence number one 3 or 4 times. I'm going to read it fast the first time. Try and listen and get as much as you can. And then I will pause, and then I will repeat it and slow down. Okay? So everybody ready? All right, so this one's a little bit long. The teenage girl read 7 of her 10 magazines on Wednesday. Again. The teenage girl read 7 of her 10 magazines on Wednesday. Again, the teenage girl read 7 of her 10 magazines on Wednesday. One more time, really slow. The teenage girl read 7 of her 10 magazines on Wednesday. All right.
Is magazines a Z?
Yes, it is. Magazines.
I didn't have spelled
with an S at the end. If it's plural. Remember,
does
plural.
Does it have an S at the end?
What's that?
Does it have an S at the end?
No, you would only say that like on Wednesdays. I exercise on Wednesdays. That means every Wednesday. So, let's see.
That's
no, it's Wednesday is spelled correctly. So maybe, We're gonna go. You're gonna check that. So, who? Wait a second. Who would like to write it on the board? Anybody? Yes. Oh, you went. So, is there anybody else that would like to? No. Okay. You got it.
I go with it.
I'll help you out. Or we can all help you out. We'll see. So, pick a color. Okay. So, oh, do you have your paper? Yeah, well, a lot of people do, but that's something we're going to work on this year. I think before Christmas, long before that, you should learn how to spell Wednesday very easily. All right, so the teenage girl, red, 7. Yep, the only time you're going to capitalize a word is as if it's a proper noun. So a proper noun is the name of a person or a place. Like Kevin is a proper noun. Nathan is a proper noun. Alakakit is a proper noun. Is boy a proper noun?
Yeah.
No. It's the name of a specific person or place is a proper noun. So Kevin is a specific person, so that's capitalized. Rhea is a proper noun. That's a name of a person. Is city a proper noun?
No.
No. But is Alaska a proper noun?
Yeah.
It's a specific place. Yes.
Is that how you spell Wednesday?
With an E in here. So let's just make room there.
Oh, I know it. W-E-E-F-E-S-P-A-Y.
Okay, very good. And, wait a second. Here, here, take a look.
A.
And, so here, come back. Yeah?
Yeah.
And E. Ooh. All right, perfect. The teenage girl, red. Yep, that's okay. That's what this is for, right? To help. 7 of her 10 magazines on Wednesday. And take a look at that. Wednesday. Looks weird, doesn't it? Looks different than how it sounds. Wednesday. Okay, so check your work. Make sure yours looks exactly like this. You're okay. You just write right below it. Okay, so you know what? One more thing here. Let's make sure that this M looks like a small M. Because magazines is not a proper noun, so it has a lowercase m. Okay, so does yours look exactly like this?
I capitalized the W on Wednesday.
Yes, because that is it's already capitalized for you. That's why I put that there. All the days of the week are always capitalized. Okay, just like the months of the year. And the names of cities and states and country and people, those are all capital letters. The first letter is always capitalized. All right, so let's go on to the next part. Noun. We have 3 nouns in this sentence. 3 nouns in this sentence. Well, wait a second. All right, so let everybody... Let's get everybody a chance here. So, just Grace, name one of the nouns. Magazines. And this is what we call, so draw a circle, write an N above or below it. This is what we call a plural noun. Have you heard that word before? Plural? We have singular, which means one. Plural means more than one. So this is magazines. So that's a plural noun. It just means more than one. All right, who can tell me?
Girl.
Another noun. Yes, girl. Girl, so draw a circle, a blue circle. Write the N above or below it. And we have one more noun. One more noun. Yes?
Three.
No, no.
Seven. Ten.
Ten. No, this is a hard one.
Hurry.
Wednesday. Wednesday. Yeah. Wednesday.
Blue.
Yes, because it's a noun, and we're going to write an N above or below it. Now, let's move on to a verb, and let's make sure that we underline the verb this time. With red, a red verb. So, take a look here. Now, remember, we're looking for an action verb. It's something that they're doing. And usually it's something that the subject, and who is the subject? The girl. Yeah, it's the person or thing that's doing something. And what is she doing? Or what did she do?
Read.
Yeah, and in this case, it's the past tense. So the teenage girl read. Read. Seven. So she did it in the past. She did it on Wednesday. Okay? So underline with your red crayon and write a V either above or below it so we know that it's the verb. Sometimes sentences have more than one verb. Sometimes they have many verbs. And we're going to learn there are different kinds of verbs, but today we're just talking about action verbs. Okay, moving on. Take your green crayon. Okay, now we're looking for adjectives.
Teenage,
yes. What kind of girl? Teenage girl.
A square box.
Yep, a box. And let's write an A above or below it. Okay, so adjectives are words that describe, and numbers and colors are also adjectives, right? So if it said a blue box, okay, blue is an adjective. So colors and numbers are adjectives. But for today, we're just doing this main adjective that describes the girl. Okay, so before we move on, we have one more thing. Do you remember what we're doing too? Remember, we're combining English and math today. So,
write the 7-10.
The fraction, yes. So, it's, what is it?
7-10.
Yeah. 10 magazines. How many magazines did she read? 7 out of 10 magazines on Wednesday. So, 7/10. Very good. All right. Any questions about number one? Okay, so let's move
on.
Yeah, just write this out for the side because this is the fractions part. This is the math part that we're doing. Because here it is. 7, she read 7 of her 10 magazines. Yeah, this is how math creeps into your everyday life. This is how fractions creep into your everyday life. All right, so are you ready for number two? Count the number of words.
Ten.
How many?
Ten.
10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. 10 words. All right. All right, anybody want to guess the first word?
The.
The. Yeah. All right, remember, capitalize the first letter of the first of the
and
sentence.
The next one is...
I don't think you're going to be able to guess that one.
Adjective.
You think?
Yeah, because the second one is adjective.
It's not always like that, though. We'll figure it out. We'll see. We'll see if Kevin is right. Okay, are you ready? I'm going to say this four times. The very young children listened to their teacher during class. Again. The very young children listened to their teacher during class. Okay? Again, I'll slow it down. The very young children listened to their teacher during class. Last time, the very young children listened to their teacher during class. Okay, so you have a space missing, so make sure. Okay, anybody?
You know there's three of theirs?
I do, of course. And you can tell us which one then. All right, so who wants to write it on the board? Anybody?
I do.
You don't have to have it perfect to write it on the board. We can make corrections. You don't have to have it perfect.
You have to have like a teacher?
Nope. Yeah, it's not a proper noun.
How do we write the...
I will.
Okay, come on up.
How do we write listen?
You're going to find that out. So watch when Rhea... Here you go. Rhea, you can use this one. So, yeah. All right, so pick a color. And make sure you write large enough so everybody can see. Everybody has the first word already. The should have a capital T. Yeah, make sure you write it big enough. You don't have to write it way up there. Which one do you want? How about this one? Always shows up really well. You don't have to write it way up there. Just make sure it's big enough for everyone to see. So check that. Here, take a look.
Can I go to the bathroom?
Listened. Yep. That's another word where you can't really hear the T. Hurry up so you don't miss much. The very young children. Okay. Yep, listened. Yes, and that word you don't hear the T. So we don't say listened. It's just listen. It's like the word whistle, you know. Whistle. That also has S-T, but you don't hear the T. Yeah, so we don't pronounce it like that. Yeah. Whistle. Whistle. Listen. Yeah. Okay, so thank you very much. The very young children listen to their teacher during class. Did you write Did you use the correct there? This is possessive. Okay. Whose teacher? Their teacher. Okay? Possessive pronoun. Alright, so check your work. Now on your page they already have we already wrote the period at the end. Okay? Nathan, check your sentence. Make sure it's exactly like there. Make sure this is a small c. A small c. And this is also a small v. So if you write in big, sometimes you can confuse it for a capital letter. So, right? So the only letter in the sentence that's a capital is the first letter. Check yours. Make sure you have it the same as what you wrote up here. All right, so let's pick up our blue crayon. How many nouns do we have in this sentence?
Four.
Two.
We have more than two.
Five. Four.
Three.
Three. Three. All right, so who can tell me one? Raise your hand. Nathan?
Listen.
No, that's going to be...
Teacher.
Teacher will be one, so draw a circle, write an N. Kevin?
Ready?
No.
Class?
Class. And Grace?
Children.
Children. And that's a noun. Remember I just told you about plural nouns? Yeah, children, that's more than one child, so children is a plural noun. Plural. Alright, so those are our three nouns. Let's pick up our red crayon. Alright, we're going to do just one main verb here. And what's the verb? What are they doing? What are the children doing?
Listen.
Yeah, what did they do? Yeah, they listened. So let's draw underline, listen, and write your V. Above or below it. And pick up your green crayon. We're looking for adjectives. So, what kind of children?
Young.
Young children. Yes, so let's draw a box around that and write an A. Young children. Okay, so now turn your paper over. Now we're not going to use the space.